The TOT, Soca Village Calypso Tent, has chosen the theme Blending Youth with Experience 2023 and beyond, as it looks to get more young talent interested in the Calypso art form. The tent will put on its first event on May 27th at the National Cultural Center. Calypso enthusiasts are being invited in large numbers to patronize the events. Part of the proceeds from the events held will go towards funding the rebuilding of a home for the Monsignor Patrick Anthony Folk Research Center.
We have been developing a number of workshops focused on the youth. And one of the persons who is spearheading that is Nadez Charles, together with Sasky. And they have put a program in place whereby we are going to ensure that the young people who are coming into the arena, they are properly groomed. So much so that apart from the stage presentation, voicing, and all the work that is going to be done, we are ensuring that we are going to put them into a setting of a club, whereby it could be every Saturday that they would have a home where they would come and be exposed to the writing, the voicing, stage management, and so on. So at the end of the day, we know that we have a new crop of persons who will not only take on the stage as singers, but also production and all other elements of production.
Chairman of the Carnival Music Management Company, Claude Paul, who was also present at the launch, has emphasized the need for performers to familiarize themselves with the rules of the competition. The National Calypso Monarch competition will take place on July 8th.
We saw recently the formation of a judges association, and I believe that if we continue to work with them in the right way, we can find ways to improve the whole act of judging Calypso and Soca as well, because there is seem to be a distinction between the two, a discomfort on the part of some people to judge Soca, because it's, you know, people who are accustomed of judging Calypso find a challenge judging Soca. And I understand that there's some activity taking place towards the end of the month where some Soca expert judge from Trinidad is coming down to give some training to our Soca judges, and that will help to widen the pool. Because what some of the difficulties we have every year is finding people who want to judge and who are capable of judging.
Meanwhile, the opening of the submission of applications for the 2023 National Groovy and Power Soca competition has been announced. This year, the submission of applications will be done digitally by completing an electronic form on the Carnival St. Lucia website. This move to digital form submissions is one of many steps that the Carnival Planning and Management Committee will take aimed at the overall improvement of St. Lucia Carnival for participating contestants and all stakeholders. There were complaints of the quality of music coming out of last year's event. President of the Carnival Bands Association, Barry George, hopes that more effort will be placed in creating music that can be marketed beyond the island shores.
The music plays an integral part in Carnival, and every year we look forward to hoping that our artists would bring good music, and music that that could be enjoyed not just for locals but for the bigger diaspora and also international, because normally when your music do burst during the Carnival season, it spread into Miami Carnival, Labor Day and Caribbean. So we're hoping that our artists are working hard, and when they're releasing their music, the thought process are thinking towards music that lends to an international appeal, that everybody can enjoy it, and not just specific just to St. Lucia as well.
The deadline for submission of applications for the Groovy and Power Soca Monarch is at midnight Monday, June 5th, 2023. The competition will be held on Friday, July 7th. For the DBS News World, I am Zin Romulus.